got a session in here originally recorded in Pro Tools using Apogee, some high-end converters, recorded at 44.1 at 24-bit. Got all the WAV files from the individual tracks now imported here in DP. And I was setting up and getting ready to start mixing and just ran through it. I just put it in here, no effects, no EQ, no nothing, just the straight files right now. First of all, just by looking at it, I can see it was recorded fairly hot. All the drums definitely fairly hot. And I was listening to it, and I came down to this part here and listening, and I just heard a noise, just some stuff. Let's play it right there. You heard there was like a clipping. Let's play it again. So we can just by the overview we can see there's could be an issue there. Could also be an issue there. So let's take the vocals out, take the guitars, bass out. So let's just listen to the drums. There it is. It's definitely a drum track, and it looks like it's this, which is overhead. So let's make this a little bigger. Let's zoom in and see what's going on. And now, zoomed in. So this is the left overhead. So we can see there's some soft clipping or something going on the right overhead. But the left, there's something odd going on. The first three valleys here, after the initial attack, there's this spike that gives that clip sound. So here in DP, what I'll do, let's mark them right where they are. Let's make some markers. One marker. Two marker. And third one. And let's open it up so we can see. It's called overhead 01. Left 610. So let's go to the waveform overview and let's go select overhead 01 left 610. So here we are. There's a couple of ways you, by the way, you can zoom here. Of course, we can always zoom like this and then move around. You can also see here you have the full waveform you're looking at, and what's in this window selection here showing you what you're actually seeing in the window down here. So just if I move my cursor up here and you see it's changed to this horizontal hand, and if I hold click and hold, I can move, and now you'll see go to the end of it, go the other way. So basically now I'm zooming in on this particular part of the full wave of the full wave file. Now let's go to the first marker 3, 2, so it's around here. And there they are. So we can see the first one is here. So to repair this, I'll simply select the pencil tool. Now you'll see the pencil tool doesn't work. The reason being, now I'm zoomed too far in. So let's zoom out a little bit. Not enough. Zoom out a little bit more. And then all of a sudden the pencil tool. So I don't know if this is a feature or that feature is really an undocumented feature. But anyway, I got my pencil tool, and now I simply just draw something in here so we get rid of that spike. Let's go down, find the next spike, do the same thing. I randomize my movement with my cursor a little bit. So let's make this nice and round. So there we go. And hit save. There's probably more of these, I have a suspicion. zoom out. It's just weird to see those first three that this was happening there. Let's go down to the next part. Oh, seems like I have to. There's one more here. I have no idea how that happened. If it's converter, microphone, Pro Tools, whatever. If you have a guess, I'll be really interested to know. I contacted the studio. I didn't get a answer. Just thought they might want to know what's going on. Anyway, to me, almost looked like they recorded it for drum replacement. But if we want to keep the performance, please give us something that's not this hot. Let's go back to the sequence. Let's scroll back and just play this. And now you can hear there's no click when we're playing it. Perfect. So that's the pencil tool in Digital Performer, helping a good recording be better.